So today we are going to start with ischemic heart diseases. Ischemic heart diseases, we have already studied about the process of arteriosclerosis or atherosclerosis. So now we are going to study the heart diseases of the ischemia category. Ischemic heart diseases are primarily of two types. Number one, angina, and number two, myocardial infarction. Angina is again of three types: stable angina, Prinz metal angina, and unstable angina. Myocardial infarction can be categorized into two: non-ST elevation MI, N-STEMI, and number two, STEMI, ST elevation MI. STEMI refers to ST elevation MI. ST is the ST segment in the ECG. Then ischemic heart disease can cause sudden cardiac death, right? The cardiac tissue dies, as a result the organism also dies, the human also dies. So sudden cardiac death, if it is too much severe, then it can cause sudden cardiac death. And in chronic ischemic heart diseases, it can lead to ischemic cardiomyopathy. Ischemic cardiomyopathy. Sudden cardiac death, we will deal with sudden cardiac death in heart failure in later lectures, and ischemic cardiomyopathy in other lectures where we will deal with cardiomyopathy. Right? So in this, we are going to deal with angina and myocardial infarction. So first is definition. Definition of ischemic heart disease. So ischemic heart disease is a condition resulting from myocardial ischemia, right? We already know what is ischemia. When ischemia takes place in the myocardial tissue, in the myocardial cells, then we call that as myocardial ischemia. So as ischemia, as the definition of ischemia, the definition of myocardial ischemia will become, it is the imbalance between myocardial supply and cardiac demand for oxygenated blood. Right, whenever the supply of the blood and the demand for the blood, the oxygenated blood, is imbalanced, is not properly matched, then it can lead to ischemia of myocardial type, myocardial ischemia. Ischemic diseases of the heart, they can present themselves as acute conditions, acute troubles, or they may present as chronic troubles, right? That means they can be immediate in onset as in acute, or they may be gradual on onset, right? Chronic stable conditions. The acute conditions of the heart are emergency conditions, and they are called as acute coronary syndromes. The acute emergency conditions pertaining to ischemia of the heart are called as acute coronary syndromes, ACS. And the chronic conditions which are not emergency, which are stable, are called as chronic coronary artery disease, CAD, coronary artery diseases. So coronary artery diseases is a group of disease which are chronic, and acute coronary syndromes are group of diseases which are acute and they are emergency. Right? So ischemic heart disease can also be categorized into acute and chronic. Acute is acute coronary syndromes, and chronic diseases are chronic coronary artery diseases. So these acute coronary syndromes, which are acute emergency conditions, they are the myocardial infarctions, both types, STEMI and non-STEMI, and the unstable variant of angina, unstable angina. The chronic coronary artery diseases are stable angina. We are not classifying the Prinz metal angina in this, because it neither falls into acute condition neither falls into chronic condition. It cannot be categorized on this classification. Then the causes for ischemic heart diseases. Why the heart muscle, or why the heart goes into ischemia, why the supply of the blood and supply of the oxygenated blood and nutrients to the heart tissue goes down, is reduced. So the causes for ischemic heart diseases are, number one, coronary atherosclerosis. 90% of the cause is coronary atherosclerosis, or 90% of the cases are having the causes of coronary atherosclerosis. We have already talked about coronary atherosclerosis in detail. The second common cause is coronary artery thrombosis, right? When the coronary artery becomes thrombosed, the thrombus plugs the coronary artery. Accordingly, embolisms can also cause coronary blockage. Embolisms like fat embolisms, like air embolisms, right, or like thromboembolisms, where thrombus from some other part of the body, for example, most common site is the veins of the legs. So from the veins of the legs, the thrombus, they travel, they come into the heart and they block the coronary supply. Then another rare causes are vasospasm, right? The coronary artery becomes spastic, it goes into spasms, and because of unknown reasons it goes into spasm, and that spastic coronary artery, the vasospasms of the coronary artery, leads to ischemia of the heart. Stenosis is again the compression of the collapsing of the coronary artery, stenosis. Then arteritis, the inflammation of the coronary artery, compression by some other tumors, right? The tumor may compress the coronary artery and it can block the supply of the heart. So let us talk about atherosclerosis. For example, we have already discussed the blood supply of the heart, where the right coronary, the arc of aorta, divides into two branches, the left coronary artery, and the right coronary artery. The left coronary artery again divides into two, LAD, left anterior descending branch, and LCX, left circumflex artery. Right. So whenever this coronary artery becomes narrow, right, because of atherosclerosis, the atheromas in it, we call that as atherosclerosed coronary artery. So the pathophysiology of ischemic heart disease is very simple to understand. Because of the atherosclerosis, the progressive narrowing of the artery takes place, narrowing of the coronary arteries, epicardial means the surface, the left and the right coronary arteries, right? Epicardial coronary artery means the coronary arteries of the epicardium. So they become atherosclerosed and they become narrow, they become hardened. And this leads to reduced blood supply to the heart. Heart means reduced blood supply to the heart muscle, which is called as myocardial ischemia. And when this reduced blood supply is not enough to maintain the physiology of the heart, to maintain the functioning of the heart, the symptoms of myocardial ischemia manifest, or the symptoms of ischemic heart diseases manifest. So we already know that the heart performs electrical and mechanical functions, right? Electrical functions, the passage of the electricity, the passage of the signal from SA node to AV node and to the left ventricle, to the muscles of the heart. And the mechanical functions, that is pushing of blood into the aorta and receiving blood, right? So the mechanical functions, this is systole and diastole. So myocardial ischemia disturbs the electrical and mechanical functions of the heart. Now this myocardial ischemia, it manifests into four categories of diseases. Number one category is angina. When this myocardial ischemia, that is the reduced blood supply to the heart, is less than or equal to 20 minutes, that is it is transient, it is for a less period of time, right, then it leads to angina, and angina is reversible. Reversible means as soon as the ischemia, the blockage is reduced or the blood vessel dilates, the heart muscle starts getting the blood supply and the ischemia, the damage happened to the muscles, the heart muscles are reversed, right? So angina, the damage is reversible because the ischemia is transient. Then number two, myocardial infarction. When this myocardial ischemia is prolonged, that is, it is greater than 20 minutes, then the cardiac tissue becomes so much damaged, the cardiac tissue becomes infarcted, or the cardiac tissue becomes necrosed. The necrosed and infarction are almost similar. We will talk about myocardial infarction in the next lecture. So when the ischemia is prolonged greater than 20 minutes, then the damage to the heart muscle becomes irreversible, and we call that condition as myocardial infarction, which is also called as heart attack. Then sudden cardiac death and ischemic cardiomyopathies. So let us talk about the angina pectoris. As a physician, you should know about angina pectoris, because heart disease is still one of the most important causes for untimely death, for the morbidity, for the mortality, right? And it is also a very prevalent in the society. So you should know what is angina, what is MI. So angina pectoris. So we have already studied that myocardial ischemia, which is less than or equal to 20 minutes, right? If the blood supply of the heart is interrupted for less than 20 minutes, it produces angina, right? Now, what is angina? Angina is a clinical syndrome. The definition is angina is a clinical syndrome which is characterized by episodic chest pain or discomfort. Right, episodic means it comes in episodes. That means it will come today, it might come tomorrow, or it might come after a week, or it might come after a month, right? So it is episodic, it comes in episodes, just like asthmatic attacks. So episodic chest pain means chest pain, right? Pain in the chest. More often the chest pain is called as chest discomfort, because in very less patients the chest pain is actually a pain. It is in majority of the patient, it is not pain, it is discomfort. We will talk about this discomfort. So types of angina. The angina is of three types: stable angina, unstable angina, also called as crescendo angina, and number three, Prinzmetal variant angina, or Prinzmetal angina. Let us talk about stable angina. Stable angina is also the typical angina, right? This stable angina is the substernal, right? Substernal means behind the sternum. It is the chest discomfort with a characteristic quality and duration, right? Quality and duration. So this chest discomfort has a specific quality and duration. The quality of this chest discomfort is generally described as heaviness. The patient will say that my chest is very heavy, right? It feels that my chest is having too much weight over it. Pressure, that somebody is pressurizing over my chest. Squeezing pain, somebody is squeezing my chest. Smothering means it is blocking. Somebody is blocking the chest. Somebody is putting pressure over it. Or choking, right? Choking feeling. As you get a choking feeling when you're drowning. So smothering is when somebody is obstructing, somebody is closing your nostril, somebody is trying to kill you. That is smothering feeling or choking feeling, right? And rarely patient describe it as a pain. Okay, chest pain. The person, most of the time the patients don't tell that it is a chest pain. They just say that my chest is very heavy. I cannot breathe. It feels like somebody has put a heavy weight over my chest. My chest has become very heavy, right? This pain usually lasts 2 to 5 minutes, right? It lasts from 2 to 5 minutes, and after 2 to 5 minutes, it relieves on its own. right? It is relieved on its own as the patient rests, right? Sometimes it can radiate either to left shoulder. Most commonly it radiates to left shoulder. Sometimes it might radiate to right shoulder also, or sometimes it also radiates to the chin, to the jaw, or towards the neck, or sometimes towards the umbilicus, or sometimes even towards the back side. But most commonly it radiates to the left arm. So when this person is having pain, what causes the episodes of the pain? Stress or exertion provokes the chest pain. So this person who has atherosclerosis, the most important cause, the person who has atherosclerosis in his coronary arteries, on stress, right, any type of stress, any physical exertion, if he is exercising, if he or she is exercising or walking very fast or doing some physical activity, or some mental stress, some emotions, or some heavy meal or something, some other mental stress, some bad news, then that physical or mental stress leads to the increased heart rate. And increased heart rate means the heart muscle requires more blood, but the coronary arteries are occluded, the coronary arteries are narrowed because of the atherosclerosis, most commonly because of the atherosclerosis, and thus this physical or mental stress causes the episodes of angina. So this person, whenever, let us say, whenever he walks fast, he will start developing a chest discomfort, right? And as soon as he rests, as soon as he stops the activity, lies down, the chest discomfort will be relieved, right? So students, always remember, angina, the stable angina pain, is relieved by rest and is aggravated or provoked by stress, and it never lasts more than 2 to 5 minutes, right? Right? Anyways, the ischemia itself never lasts for greater than 20 minutes. So next type of angina is Prinz metal variant angina. In Prinz metal variant angina, it is basically because of the coronary artery spasms. Because of no reasons or because of unknown reasons, the coronary artery goes into various spastic conditions. The coronary artery collapses on its own, right? It goes into spasms, and that leads to reduced blood flow, resulting in myocardial ischemia or transient myocardial ischemia, leading to Prinz metal angina, right? ECG, we will talk about ECG in the practical classes mostly, right? But you can remember for now that there could be transient ST segment elevations in this Prinz metal variant angina, and which is because of transmural ischemia, right? Transmural and subendocardial ischemia, we will talk about this in myocardial infarction, right? So if patient is given some vasodilators, some medicine, some drugs which dilate the blood vessels, so such medicines release the angina. For example, most commonly nitroglycerin, the sorbitrate tablets. The people who have angina, chronic angina, they keep the sorbitrate tablets with them, and as soon as they feel chest discomfort, they suck this tablet, right? Nitroglycerin. Then third type of angina is unstable or crescendo angina, right? Crescendo angina. This is called crescendo angina because it happens in a crescendo pattern. Crescendo pattern means greater than the last episode, more than the last episode. For example, if last episode the pain was for 2 minutes, then in next episode it will be for 5 minutes, right? The specificity of unstable angina is that the chest discomfort will be of a greater time period, right? It might cross even 20 minutes, right? So chest discomfort greater than 20 minutes, and this chest discomfort generally appears at rest, right? It appears at rest. When the person is resting, the person will develop a chest pain which will be greater than 20 minutes, and it will be episodic, and the episodes will be more severe and prolonged episodes. The recent episodes will be more severe and prolonged. They will be severe, the pain will be more, and they will be of greater duration. Right? Now, what causes this unstable angina? Basically, it is a pre-infarction condition. We will talk about infarction in myocardial infarction. Now, let us focus on ischemia. So, what happens that the atherosclerotic plaques, they undergo some complex changes. We have already studied about these complex changes previously, where we have studied that the plaques, they might develop calcification, they might develop ulcerations, they might develop thrombosis, they might develop hemorrhages, they might develop aneurysms, right? So these atherosclerotic plaques, because of the hyperdynamicity of the blood or because of the fast moving blood, these atherosclerotic plaques, the collagen cap of these atherosclerotic plaques, it ruptures, which leads to the exposure of the core of the atherosclerotic plaque, which contains the fatty substances. Exposure of the core to the blood leads to the formation of a blood clot inside the blood vessel, which is called as thrombus, right? So a thrombus is superimposed over the atherosclerotic plaque, right? And sometimes this thrombus at its own site occludes the blood vessel completely, or sometimes this thrombus detaches itself from the prime site and occludes some other smaller blood vessel and is called as thromboembolism and causes thromboembolism, right? And that thromboembolism causes chest discomfort greater than 20 minutes because it completely occludes the blood vessels, and that is referred as unstable angina, right? Now, in this unstable angina, if we take an ECG, there will be ST segment depression. And after the chest discomfort is relieved, these ST segment depressions will again become normal. The ST segment will again become an isoelectric line. It will become flattened line. Right. Now, this unstable angina is basically similar to the MI, the myocardial infarction. But in unstable angina, because the patient is having some good luck, the ischemic tissue, the ischemic myocardial tissue does not go into myocardial necrosis. Thus, the biomarkers of the necrosis of cardiac muscle, that is cardiac troponin I and T, they are absent, right? So, we can say in unstable angina, there is no necrosis / infarction. There is no infarction, right? Apart from that, it is similar to that of myocardial infarction. The chest discomfort greater than 20 minutes is similar to that as that of myocardial infarction, right? So such type of pain, which is prolonged, which is severe, and which is in a crescendo pattern, is called as unstable angina. Investigation. So, when angina is developing, when a person is having chest pain, if at that time if we take an ECG, it might show ST segment depression, the T wave flattening. T wave is an upright wave, right? It goes up, it becomes flattened, or sometimes it may become inverted also, right? But most of the patients, as soon as they reach the hospital, their chest pain is gone. And they complain about the chest pain, you know, one hour back or 2 hours back or half an hour back, like that. For them, we do the exercise stress ECG, also called as TMT, treadmill test. We make the patient to walk or to run over a treadmill and we attach the electrodes over his heart, over his chest, then we take the ECG. Such ECG, when the patient goes into the stress of running, stress of walking, in such ECGs, the ST segment depressions are visible. Right? So if a person is showing an ECG change on exercising, then we say that the person is having an angina. Number two, cholesterol, the lipid levels, the dyslipidemia, the features of dyslipidemia and the investigations of dyslipidemia will be there, right, where there will be less high density lipids and increased amount of cholesterol, low density lipids and triglyceride levels, right. Number three and most important investigations is coronary angiography. Angio means blood vessels, coronary means coronary blood vessels, and graphy means we take the graph, we make the structure. So what we do, we put a radio contrast dye into the coronary artery and we take the x-rays, and these x-rays and the film is called as angiograph. So this radio contrast dye is put into the coronary artery and it fills the coronary arteries. As the x-rays passes through the heart, the coronary arteries are now radio opaque, so they come as black. So the dye, if there is some flow inhibition, if the blood cannot flow properly through these arteries, it is visible in the x-rays as small spastic pictures, right? The coronary arteries will be spastic at the point of atherosclerosis, right? So this radio contrast dye is injected into the coronary artery. So we put a catheter, right? Just like an intravenous catheter, we put a catheter into the radial artery or into the brachial artery, into the femoral artery, and we, at that catheter is very long, we take that catheter from the femoral artery to the aorta. To the aorta, and from the aorta we inject that dye into the coronary artery. Nowadays, even we take a CT angiography, CT coronary, CT angiogram, and in that we directly inject the dye into the brachial artery, into the radial artery, right? So coronary angiography using x-ray, simple x-rays, or coronary angiography via CT scans. So keep studying.